Today's story is called A Long, Long Walk. The memory verse is from Isaiah chapter 6, verse 8. It says, "Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, 'Whom shall I send? And who will go for us?' And I said, 'Here am I. Send me.'" Today's message is, "I will listen when God calls me to serve him." "I don't want to move," Mika groaned. "Neither do I," Anya replied. "Dad said he felt the Lord wanted him to take the new job. I wonder how he knows what God wants." "Let's ask him," Mika suggested. "Dad, we need to ask you something," Anya whispered, tugging at Dad's shirt. "How can you be sure God wants us to move?" "That's probably the same question someone asked Abraham when God told him to move," Dad said. "Let me tell you a story." Abram loved God. He talked with God often during the day. He wanted to do whatever God said. One day, God spoke to Abram. "It is time for you to leave Ur, Abram. You must leave all your friends and go to a place that I will show you." Abram must have been speechless. Why would God want him to leave his home and go someplace else to live? God continued, "I will bless you, Abram. I will give you children and grandchildren and great-grandchildren. Your family will grow into a mighty nation. You will be greatly blessed." Now that must have made Abram wonder, for he and his wife Sarai did not have even one child. Nevertheless, Abram and Sarai chose to obey God. They packed up all their belongings. Abram's servants folded and packed all the tents. The time had come to leave. Abram called together all those who would go with them. Lot, Abram's nephew, joined the group. All the people who worked in Abram's house and the people Abram had taught to worship God also got ready to go. They loaded their donkeys and camels and began their long journey. Abram, Sarai, their family members, and their servants walked the dusty road day after day. The sun was so hot. But through it all, God provided for them. Finally, the caravan reached the land of Canaan. But still, Abram and Sarai, their people, their donkeys, and their camels traveled on. When would they stop? Where was God leading them? In Shechem, a place where many Canaanites lived, there was a forest of trees called the Great Trees of Morah. When Abram reached the forest of Morah, he called to his servants, "Halt! Set up the camp here." As the servants prepared the camp, God appeared and spoke to Abram. "Look around you, Abram," God said. "This is the land that I am going to give you and your family." Abram looked around. He saw a wide, grassy valley with softly rolling hills. He saw olive trees, fig trees, and springs of cool water everywhere. But Abram also saw something that made him very sad. Among the trees, he saw altars that were used to worship idols. Abram immediately gathered stones to build an altar. He wanted to worship God and thank him for being with them during their journey. He wanted to tell God that he was willing to go anywhere God wanted. He was willing to do whatever God asked him to do. And so, Dad told Anya and Mika. We need to be willing to listen to God, just as Abram was. God spoke words directly to Abram. Today, he may speak to us directly, through his word, the Bible, or through the counsel of people who are following him. Your mother and I are glad to serve where God sends us. And when we are willing, God lets us know what he wants. He gives us understanding and helps us know in our hearts what he wants us to do. Today's story is called Abram to the Rescue. The memory verse is from Galatians chapter 5, verse 13. It says, "Serve one another in love." Today's message is, "I will serve others out of love." When elderly Mr. Gomez became sick and had to spend a long time in the hospital, Ronnie, Cameron, Aiden, and Ariana decided to help Mrs. Gomez. Without saying a word, they cut her grass and cleaned her yard and would not accept any money. On the way home, they felt as if they were walking on air. And that must be exactly the same feeling that Abram had the day he met Melchizedek. It all started when four great enemy kings led their huge army to war against five little cities. One of the little cities was Sodom. Abram's nephew, Lot, lived in Sodom. The kings of the five little cities took their armies into the valley of Siddim. "We can surprise the four great enemy kings," they said. "Let us stop their army and save our cities." And so King Bera of Sodom led the way. But it didn't go as planned. They got lost among the huge tar pits in the valley, and many of the soldiers fell into the tar. The four great enemy kings knew their way around the tar pits, and soon they got to the city of Sodom. Enemy soldiers captured the people, including Lot. They carried the people and many of their animals and other things away. One captive escaped and ran to tell Abram what had happened. "The four great enemy kings attacked us. Your nephew Lot is captured along with all of his family," the man reported. At once, Abram called his 318 men who were trained to fight. He also asked three of his neighbors who were leaders to bring their people to join with him. Together, they hurried after the four great enemy kings. Can you imagine Abram and his little band chasing after the four great enemy kings and their thousands of trained soldiers? Surely they would destroy Abram's little group. But Abram had God on his side. Surely Abram prayed for God's help all the way north to Dan. That's where he caught up with the four great enemy kings. During the night, Abram and his men made a surprise attack. The four great enemy kings thought that they were completely surrounded by a huge army. They dropped everything and ran. They left the captives, all the stolen things from Sodom, and their own things. The frightened soldiers ran all the way north past Damascus to Hobah. Lot and the other captives from Sodom were soon set free. Everyone began gathering up the things left by the defeated enemy kings. Soon they began traveling back toward Sodom. How happy Abram was! God had used him to save Lot and all the families from Sodom. On the way back, Abram's band entered the Valley of Shava, not far from where Jerusalem is today. There, the king of Sodom came out to meet them. Imagine how impressed this king must have been. Abram, his herdsmen, and the three neighbors had, with God's help, done what five kings could not. Melchizedek, king of Salem, and a priest who served God also came to welcome Abram and the others. Melchizedek brought food and drink for Abram and his men. The kingly priest prayed over Abram and blessed him, saying, "Blessed be Abram by God Most High, creator of heaven and earth, who delivered your enemies into your hands." Abram knew that God gave him the victory, so he gladly counted out all the silver and gold and flocks that he brought back. He gave the kingly priest God's tithe of everything, one of every 10 animals, pieces of silver, and pieces of gold. The king of Sodom saw all the things Abram gave as tithe. Gratefully, he told Abram to keep for himself all the rest. "Give me the people and keep the goods," he said. But Abram would not take anything for himself. He only asked for a share that the neighbors who had helped him were owed. Abram was happy to serve others just for the love of helping them. Today's story is called Heavenly Visitors. The memory verse is from Philippians chapter 2, verse 4. It says, "Not looking to your own interests, but each of you to the interests of the others." Today's message is God wants me to speak out for others. Do you talk to God when someone you care about needs help? Do you ask God to do something for them? Even when people are bad, we can speak out for them. A long time ago, Abraham bargained with God for some people. It happened like this. One hot day, Abraham sat in the shade of his tent, looking out upon the valley where he lived. A movement caught his eye. Three men stood just beyond his camp, talking together. Abraham jumped up, ran out to meet them, and bowed low. "Please, stay a while at my tent. I will give you water and some food to eat. You can sit in the shade of the trees and rest." "Thank you, we will," the men agreed. "Go, do as you have said." Abraham hurried back to the camp and into his tent. "Sarah," he called to his wife, "we have some guests. Please bake some bread for them." Then Abraham hurried to get food for his servant to cook. Soon the food was ready. Abraham himself served his guests. While they ate, he stood in the shade of a tree nearby, and Sarah stayed just inside the tent where she could listen to the men. "Where is your wife, Sarah?" one of the guests asked. "She's in the tent," Abraham answered. "Next year, at this time, she will have a son," the guest said. Back in the tent, Sarah chuckled. Imagine! A son at her age? Why did Sarah laugh? The stranger asked. Is anything too hard for the Lord? Now both Abraham and Sarah knew that their guest was the Lord himself. When Abraham's guests finished their meal, they got up to leave. As was the custom, Abraham walked a short distance with them. The Lord stopped to talk to Abraham as the others walked on. "I have heard how very wicked Sodom is," the Lord said. Abraham had heard of evil things that people did in Sodom. He thought of Lot and his family who lived there. Abraham loved his nephew's family. He was sure Lot was not wicked, but Abraham worried about the people of Sodom. Many of them did not yet know God. Lord, Abraham said, are you going to destroy the good people of Sodom along with the wicked? Suppose there are 50 good people in Sodom. Will you not save the city? The Lord answered, if I find 50 righteous or good people in Sodom, I will not destroy it. Abraham thought some more. His kind heart made him ask the Lord again, what if there are only 45 good people? I will not destroy Sodom if there are 45 good people. Still, Abraham was not satisfied. Three more times he asked the Lord to save the city. The sixth time, Abraham begged the Lord, don't be angry with me, Lord, but let me ask one more time. Will you save the city for just 10 good people? The Lord answered, for the sake of 10 good people, I will not destroy the city. Then the Lord went on to Sodom, and Abraham went back to his tent, knowing that God would do what was right and what was good. Today's story is called A Wife for Isaac. The memory verse is from Genesis chapter 24, verse 40. It says, the Lord will send his angel with you and make your journey a success. Today's message is God wants everyone to join his family. Have you ever been on a long journey? What did you take? How did you manage for food? When Abraham sent his servant on a long journey, his servant took 10 camels to carry everything he needed. Eliezer woke with a start. The sky was still black, but it was time to go. He had an important job to do. Abraham appeared out of the darkness. He smiled at his old and faithful servant. The Lord will send his angel ahead of you, my friend, he said. God will see to it that you find just the woman he has picked for Isaac's bride. She will be a woman from my homeland. We cannot let Isaac marry one of the heathen women who live here. He should marry someone who believes in God. Eliezer thought about his mission as he traveled day after dusty day. Abraham was so sure that the Lord's angel would be traveling ahead of him. He would meet many strangers. Just how would he find the right woman? Which would be the woman the Lord had picked? Finally, Eliezer arrived at the city of Nahor, where Abram's relatives lived. It was almost evening. He was tired of traveling and he was thirsty. So were the camels. Suddenly, Eliezer had an idea. He raised his head toward heaven and prayed, Lord God of my master Abraham, give me success today. Keep your promise to my master. I am here at the village well. The young women of the city will soon be coming for water. I will say to one, please lower your jar and let me have a drink. If she says drink, and I will also bring water for your camels, may she be the one you have chosen for your servant Isaac. Before Eliezer had finished praying, a beautiful young girl appeared. She came to the well and filled her water jar. Could this be the one? Eliezer wondered. He ran to meet her. Please, give me a drink of water from your jar, he asked. The girl, Rebecca, quickly lowered the jar from her shoulder. She offered it to Eliezer, and he drank his fill. Then she said the very words Eleazar had prayed for. I will also bring water for your camels. Rebecca emptied her jar into the animal's drinking trough. Then she hurried to the well for more water. Eleazar smiled joyfully. God had answered his prayer so quickly, and the girl was so friendly and so kind. When Rebecca returned, Eleazar said to her, "Please, tell me who your father is." And when she told him, Eleazar knelt down and worshipped God. "Praise the Lord, the God of my master Abraham. He has faithfully kept his promise to my master. The Lord has led me straight to my master's relatives." Rebecca went home and told her brother Laban about this servant of Abraham. Laban immediately went to the well and invited Eleazar to their home. Eleazar told them about his mission from Abraham. He told them about his prayer and how God had answered it so quickly. Would Rebecca agree to Abraham's request? Rebecca had listened carefully. She heard how God had led Eleazar to her family. She believed God was leading in this, so she agreed to go with Eleazar. She would leave her family and her homeland. She would become Isaac's wife.
Created and produced by Falvo Fowler. This podcast is read by Frenita Buddy Fullwood for Gracelink.net. Animation and artwork by Diogo Godoy. Audio is post-produced by Faith Toh at Studio Elpizo in Singapore. The theme music is by Clayton Kinney. The audio engineer was Maurice Bailey.